Artificial intelligence is taking over. Whether it's profile pictures and painted portraits in your timeline, or it's writing full-blown lesson plans that you can submit to your principal today, or it's writing the introduction to this YouTube video, artificial intelligence is making its way into our everyday lives. And as educators, we can either run away from it or we can embrace it. In this video, I want to share one of the ways that I plan on using AI to build student engagement in my classroom and hopefully get my students excited about the lessons to come. My name is Thomas Bussey. I'm a fifth grade reading teacher in Atlanta with a pretty good track record of helping my students build their reading skills and their test scores, but I'm also on a mission to end boredom in the classroom. And so hopefully by watching this video, I'll be able to help you come up with some ways that your students can be engaged and have some fun in your lessons this week. So the resource that I'm using this week is called ChatGPT. It's an artificial intelligence tool that helps you write unique ideas. For us, all we have to do is enter a prompt and it will help us come up with something new that we may not have thought of before. So in order to understand how I'm using this, I think it's important to get how I structure my classroom. So my classroom is a full-on gamified class. This means that my students are playing a year-long game where every week they have different adventures and different encounters with different characters from books that we've read or from books that are available in our classroom library. My class game is loosely based on the mechanics of Dungeons and Dragons. Now, that doesn't mean that you have to be a fan of Dungeons and Dragons or know anything about D&D in order to use some of these activities in your classroom. It's just what I use to help me generate new ideas. So in my class, on a typical Monday, I'll come in and I read my students a story. I start off with a second person perspective story, similar to what a dungeon master or a game master would do in D&D. I use that story to get them excited about the assessment that we're going to take on Friday. So what I'm going to ask ChatGPT to do today is help me build a new story that my students will get excited about. And I'll use that idea to structure our assessment, which I call a boss battle, for Friday's lesson. So let's see what it comes up with. So what I did, I asked it to write a D&D encounter for fifth graders where the villain is the Joker. So one of the key terms here that I'm using is encounter, because those typically tend to be more short form. So it's something that I can use within the span of a week. If you say a D&D adventure, it might include a bunch of different villains. That's usually a longer story. And then a campaign is something that could last you the entire school year. So sometimes it will just give you kind of a synopsis of the scenario. Sometimes it will tell you exactly what you can read to your players, or in this case, our student. If it does give me just a generic scenario, I'll ask it to write that scenario as a DM script. So a DM is a dungeon master in Dungeons and Dragons. ChatGPT understands kind of the structure of what I'm going for here. I now have a script that I can read to my students, and I can make this as grand and creative as I want it to be, or as simple as I want it to be. There are some weeks where I'll take a script like this and literally just read it on Monday and then do a boss battle on Friday. So let's look at the scenario that ChatGPT gave me.
As you are enjoying a day off in the bustling city of Atlanta, suddenly, you hear a loud explosion echo through the streets. What do? You rush towards the source of the explosion and find that the city's bank has been robbed. You see broken glass and debris scattered everywhere. As you investigate, you find clues that point to the notorious Joker as the culprit. You also hear rumors that the Joker has been sighted in a nearby abandoned amusement park. Do you decide to go to the amusement park to catch the Joker and retrieve the stolen money? You make your way through the abandoned amusement park, navigating through dilapidated carnival games and rides. You come across traps and puzzles left by the Joker, testing your skills and resourcefulness. As you continue, you hear laughter in the distance. You soon come across the Joker himself, lounging on a throne made of stacked carnival prizes, surrounded by a group of henchmen dressed as clowns. He greets you with a wicked smile.
So now I have this scenario that my students can imagine, and they have this villain that they're interested in beating. So I then asked ChatGPT to write a video script as the Joker, inviting the adventurers, in this case my students, to this broken down amusement park or to the carnival. And so it came up with a script from the Joker. I can do plenty of things with this. I can write it as a message. I could type it and leave it on the board for students to read as they come in. I could make a video as the Joker using an app like Snap Camera, add in some, you know, creepy background music and really spice it up as much as I want.
Hello, Jake. You deserve a better class of criminal, and I'm gonna give it to you. Good luck.
Or I can simply read that adventure. So typically what I'll do is I'll present it in some way, and then I go into my regular lessons, but my students understand that on Friday, we're going to have an assessment, and that assessment will be the boss battle. If you already do boss battles, you can continue with whatever mechanics that you already use. If you've never done this before, to me, the simplest thing to do is play a game like Kahoot, where you've got simple multiple choice questions, something that will instantly give you feedback on how the students are doing. But when I do something like this, I'll set a limit. Let's say there's 10 questions. If I have 25 students in my class taking the assessment at that time, I'll put, say, 7 hearts on the board for the Joker, and I'll put 5 hearts on the board for my class. Each one of those will represent their health. If 20 out of 25 students get the question right, they get to cross off 1 heart for the Joker. And if fewer than 20 students get the question right, then the class loses a heart. And their goal is to defeat the Joker at the end of the quiz. What I've found is that immersing my students in a story like this really gets them engaged. Nobody wants to lose to the Joker. Sometimes they do, but I will say at the beginning of the school year, when I did this with our vocabulary quizzes, my class average at the beginning of the year was about 65% on every quiz through the month of August. Now we're up to 85% to 95% as a class average every week, because my students are taking more time and they're studying and they're preparing properly. Maybe it's because I've motivated them so much that they want to master the English language and learn all of this vocabulary, but typically it's because they don't want to lose that boss battle on Friday. Your students who are already motivated to get A's are going to be motivated anyway. This is to help those students who love to play video games or love adventure, and this gives them some motivation and some inspiration to go home and study and do their best. So that's the basic structure, right? Tell a story on Monday, have a boss battle on Friday. When we engage our students in a story, I can guarantee you they will be more interested than when we just say, hey, here's what you need to know for a test on Friday. And being able to tell these stories has made teaching for me. I've had the most fun I've ever had these last 2.5 years since I started doing this. I hope that you'll try it out. If you do try it out, please let me know. Write it in the comments, reach out to me on Twitter or on Instagram. I love to hear about these things, so let me know how it's going. And if you need other ideas, or if you find new ways to use ChatGPT to engage your students, please, please, please share. That's about it for this video. Like, share, subscribe, all that good stuff. And I will see you next time. Happy teaching.
Did you enjoy that video? Like the video, share the video, and subscribe to the Being Mr. Bussey YouTube channel for future videos. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.